Hello and welcome to our today's release information on IHLOS Linux 10.03.500. Why 10.03.500? Unfortunately, we have to delay secure boot functionality. Therefore, we've decided to provide you all the great features with 10.03.500. 10.04.100 is on its way as soon as secure boot is available. Please note, 10.03.500 is a qualified and full-tested firmware update comparable with a major release. So today we have some information about new hardware support, client updates, and new features. With 10.03.500, IHLOS supports some new hardware. One additional device from Advantech D-Log. An industrial terminal for logistics with a fully rugged integrated keyboard. Two new devices from Advantech. These are fanless all-in-one terminals for the use in hospitals. Now we support five different SINA Workstation S from Secunet. SINA is used in government. It ensures secure data processing, storage and transmission of classified information and other sensitive data. The combination SINA and IHLOS in a virtual surrounding ensures IHL to be used for VSNFD and NATO secure environment. We have a client from Lenovo. And finally, three business notebooks from Toshiba. These notebooks have a long-lasting product lifecycle. If you're watching from the US, don't be confused if you aren't familiar with these product titles. The name of these devices are different in the US. At the moment, we are waiting for a kind of transition table from Toshiba, and we will share it with you as soon as possible. Let's have a look at some client updates. With 10.03.500, IHL brings an update on the Citrix receiver. The version 13.7.0 has been integrated. The receiver contains HDX, Adaptive Transport over EDT. What's that? Adaptive Transport is a new data transport mechanism for XenApp and XenDesktop. It's faster, more scalable, improves application interactivity, and is more interactive on challenging long-haul WAN and internet connections. Please note Citrix docs for further detailed information. You find the link in the information area under this video. The latest IHL OS 10 version supports the receiver versions 13.3.2, 13.5.0, and 13.7.0 per default. The receiver 13.8.0 will be provided with private build in January. At the same time, the new HDX Real-Time Optimization Pack 2.3.0 has been integrated, which is used for Skype for Business optimization in ECA sessions for video and bandwidth optimization. Another client update is VMware Horizon 4.6, which is the latest client VMware provides for Linux. The VMware Horizon Client 4.6 is the first client supporting Skype for Business. So from now, users are able to use Skype for Business within the VMware environment. We recommend the use of UD6 or UD9 to have full audio and video output. UD3 only can do audio output. At the moment, we are working on a facelift for UD3 for fall unified communication experience. The new UD3 is scheduled for Q1 2018 and will meet the VMware specifications for unified communications. With 10.03.500, we have some further client updates. ThinLink, Parallels, Evidion, and FabulaTech. Let's come to new features and updates. We have a new feature for IHL RDP. From now, it is possible to have a full screen session across all monitors. A new feature now also available for you AgileOS 10 is Screensaver and Command. This feature comes originally from Imprivata. Our customers love it and asked to integrate it into our firmware. Let me give you a quick demo to demonstrate this new feature. To keep the demo short, we've set the countdown duration on 5 seconds and shortened the time of the start of the countdown. Normally, we had to wait at least 1 minute. Here you see the countdown before the endpoint gets locked. So the user has a last chance to activate his endpoint before it becomes interactive. That is important for environments. The endpoint shuts down and the user has to log in again. That would be very time-consuming. The admin has the possibility to set various settings. Not only screensaver, he can also set different commands. Please check eDocs for detailed information. You find the link in the information area. For endpoint protection via DriveLock, we've enhanced the possibilities. For those who are not familiar with DriveLock, former it was called CenterTools. DriveLock solution controls the use of USB stacks within the network. It works with a BitLocker encryption to protect data on the USB stick. With 10.03.500, also the secure use of SATA disk drives is supported. Please check eDocs for detailed information. You find the link in the information area under this video. A new feature for AgileOS 10 is Device Trust. Modern workspaces imply major challenges for IT departments. Users work in a wide variety of locations, in diverse networks, and with a wide variety of devices. Nevertheless, a safety, compliance, and regulatory requirements must be met. Device Trust offers a comprehensive solution for this. Device Trust works with contextual awareness. What is that? The Device Trust solution recognizes if a user is working from outside the company network, for example from home or Starbucks, within an unsecure Wi-Fi connection. In this case, it could be he doesn't get all his apps displayed. I can give you an example. The Deutsche Bank works with a trading app that only may be used in Germany by law. So if an employee is in a foreign country, he's not able to start the app. We've created a solution brief together with Device Trust. Please check the links to the English and German version in the information area. That brings us to the end of this introduction of 10.03.500. Thank you for your attention and have a nice day.